Hi, good evening everyone, and welcome to the Miss Earth Roundpage. I'm so happy to be back on MECTV. My name is Noy Sabilano. I am the chief correspondent of Miss Earth Crown, and you are tuned in to day two. Yes, we are now on day two of the Earth Voice series, our special coverage of Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. There you go. Maraming salamat from everyone in the Philippines. And good afternoon, I believe, in Nigeria right now. So to all of our Nigerian Earthlings, thank you so much for being here. It's our honor to do this series for all of you Miss Earth fans there in Nigeria. But for now, I'd like to introduce my co-host for tonight. Well, actually, I was a co-host last night. This time, the tables are turned because he is now the co-host. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all welcome Emmanuel Feliciano. Eman, hello.
Hi, Noy. Hello. Wow. My backstage technical director job turned into a co-hosting job today. But I'm But I'm so grateful and happy. Of course, always happy to co-host this with you. And because we are back here on Miss Earth Crown after a while of resting. And we are back with the band because we are so happy that we are going to be with our very beautiful and empowered Amazons, the Miss Earth Crown 2021 candidates, right?
Exactly. And can you believe, Eman, it's already the 2021 edition of our national competitions. I mean, this is only the very first Nigeria, because we are going to have a coverage of all of the other national competitions in the coming months. So
exactly.
Stay tuned.
Here on Miss Earth Crown. So please do stay tuned for that, right?
Yes.
Wow. And correct, Noni, because it felt like just last week when we interviewed Gwen.
And then,
right? And now we're looking for the 2021 queen already.
Exactly. And I think it feels the same way for the other Miss Earth fans and all of our viewers. Maraming salamat once again for tuning in. And speaking of you, the fans, Emma, do we have any activity right now on in the comment section before we introduce our delegates?
Activity? Well, yes. We have a lot of activity. Of course, the first person, attendance check, we have Jay Give. Okay, he was here first, he said. Here first. This is so cute because Jay Give said first. And then Gab Galvez said second. And then Ralph is here with us tonight. Thank you, Ralph, for always being here. And then Neil says third. This is like an attendance check for the classroom. So there you go. And then Lori Gallant is also here with us today. Yes, okay. And then of course, Lori Gallant is from Canada. So we are not only being watched by people from the Philippines, people from Canada are also watching. And then of course, Neil from the Philippines is also here. And of course, our national director, Lisa, is here tonight. Mabuhay, Philippines. Mabuhay, Madam, and welcome to the second day.
Wow.
Rock on from Lori says, there you go. And of course, who else are here? And then, of course, we have Gabrielle Bernard. Thank you, Gabrielle, for arranging this. Thank you very much. And Carmel is actually asking, virtual pageant? You have to find out, okay, if Nigeria will hold a virtual pageant. But definitely, this is a virtual meet and greet. Okay, there you go. There you go. And of course, we also have Kosi Sotsuku Oponko. Yes, yes. Okay, there you go. And who else? We have Angela Taloza. Hello to all my Earth sisters from other side of the country. Hi, Angela, another Earth Queen from a different side of the country. Hi, hello. And of course, we have, who else are here? Chris Loy is here also. Okay, Chris Loy from Tagum City. There you go, Noy. So far, those are our comments. Noy, there you go. So far, yes. The pageant, according to Ibanabo, she's answering you already. The pageant, pre-pageant will be virtual, all but right, the grand finals will be.
So again, yeah. Yes. I'm so happy to see and hear that a lot of our fans are already sounding off in the comment section, because we're going to have a full show for tonight, starting off with the introduction of our lovely delegates for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. So let's start off with, our first delegate, right, Emma?
Yes, our first delegate. Okay. We are, because we're some of our delegates are experiencing internet connectivity issues, so we are going to introduce them by their presence on in the backstage now.
Yes.
So right now, we will go first with Sanic, okay? With Kinetic.
Okay, Sanic.
Yes. So we are going to, and let's play her intro video. Ladies and gentlemen, here she is.
Hello, lovelies. Hello, everyone. Greetings to you. I am Miss Kinetic Chiamaka Zanic, one of the delegates of Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. And my advocacy is all about promotion of afforestation for the love of trees, which has been made for a very long time, and which is part of my childhood stories. My childhood stories won't be complete if we don't talk about trees. So that is why I chose promotion of afforestation as my advocacy.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, on Miss Earth Crown TV is Sanic. Hi, Sanic.
Hello. Thank you. Hello.
There, your internet is great. I'm so happy. Once again, yes, good evening from the Philippines. Now we're going to give an opportunity to say hi to all of our fans on Miss Earth Crown. The floor is yours, Sanic.
And also, please tell us your advocacy in the...
And your advocacy.
I didn't get what you said, sorry.
Sorry. So now the floor is yours to introduce yourself and tell us about your advocacy.
Advocacy, yes.
Oh, okay. I'm Miss Kenny Chikucha Zanic, one of the delegates of Miss Earth Nigeria 2021, a graduate of Psychology, University of Nigeria. So from Nigeria, I would say good afternoon to the Philippines, to people from Canada that are watching, to my fans and friends, all of our. Okay, my advocacy is all about promotion of afforestation. I have so much love trees. It's been part of my childhood history and stories. It can never be complete without including planting of trees. Even while growing up in from my school, I have my ridges where I grow plants in school and all that. So it's been my favorite. Even in the house, I have my gardens around where I plant my trees for ventilation. You know, trees gives oxygen. It helps it beautification. It's nature. So I'm so much in love with nature. So that's why I chose afforestation as my advocacy. Planting of trees and all.
Wow. Great. You know what? This is a really great advocacy, most especially with what's happening around the world right now, with all of the forest fires and all of the floods during the typhoon season. Now, Zanic, we're going to talk more about your advocacy in detail, because I have a lot of questions about, you know, reforestation and how it affects the lives of especially women in Nigeria in a little bit. But for now, maybe we can move on to our next candidate. Zanic, first, I'd like to say this is a perfect beginning because your internet is so good. I hope it continues on until the rest, until the very last
let's
part
pray
of our show. Yeah, let's pray. Thank you, Zanic. We'll see you in a bit.
Thank you.
There you go. Wow, that's a really great first opening salvo, right, Eman?
Yes. And of course, let's continue the streak with our next candidate. Our next candidate is Edine. Edine Ofia, here goes her introduction video.
Good day, I'm Edine Ofia, delegate from Miss Earth Nigeria 2021, 2021. I'm 25 years old and a graduate of
Sociology and Anthropology, after which I proceeded to undertake courses in Human Resource Management and Sustainable Development Goals. Growing up in a family where, from a very early age, we've been taught about environmental friendly behaviors or activities that would help preserve and conserve our environment, and this has motivated me to move for my advocacy of waste management through the recycling of plastic bottles and tires to support children education. Problem of waste management is not something that is that affects just one sector or one state in my country, but goes as far as the 36 states, as these plastics are non-biodegradable, meaning they take a longer time to decay, probably hundreds of years, and they in turn occupy very large space of the landfill. My advocacy intends to have the parents or guardians of these children pick these plastic bottles, and these bottles are weighed, and the monetary value of these bottles are given to them in terms of what? Supporting your children's school fees or school supplies. The tires are also going to be used to teach them handcrafts and also decorative objects. My advocacy intends to take it one sector and one state at a time, teach my people on how to actually separate, manage their waste, and find proper use of those materials which they see as waste. Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you. Hello. Hello there.
Hi, Ezine.
Hi.
So, Ezine,
we're now going. Ladies and gentlemen. Yes. There you go, yeah.
Good day, everyone. My name is Ezine Ofia, a delegate from Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. I'm 25 years old and a graduate of sociology and anthropology. After which I proceeded to undertake various courses in business communication, human resource management, and sustainable development goals. I grew up in a family where, from a very young age, we've been taught in how to engage ourselves in environmental friendly behaviors. And this has been something that has been the bedrock of my childhood to high grade now. And it moved me to go for an advocacy in waste management through the recycling of plastic bottles and tires to support children education. I lost my mom. I lost my parents at a young age. And if there was one thing my mom always said, was the good use of separating and segregating your waste, where we use the plastic bottles to refrigerate running water and also homemade beverages. And she gave organic waste to a subsistence farmer to use as manure for their land. So having this foundation growing up, I've always known the importance of proper waste sortage and management. So that's why I intend to use these plastic bottles to support children education. And the parents or guardians of these people get to pick these plastic bottles, and this plastic bottle gets weighed, and they'll find the monetary value of this waste they're giving to them to support children education or provide them with school supplies. Using my parents, a lot of people might not be as fortunate as I was to have good extended family members who supported me. So I try to give back through an environmental friendly activity, which is what proper waste management, generating funds to help support these children education, so they can all grow up to be beautiful ladies like me and can sit here and be able to narrate this story and educate people on the importance of environmental friendly activities. And I'm also going to teach people on how to use tires to make decorative objects, and also use it to put your own little form of subsistence farming and other interior decorative items. Waste management is a problem in my country. It doesn't just affect one state, but it goes as far as affecting the whole 36 states in my country. My people need to be properly educated on how to sort and find good use of these materials which they regard as waste. So I'm starting this project with teaching people on how to find good use of their plastic bottles and also their ties. Thank you.
Wow, really impressed. You know what, Eman, I'd like to say that I am impressed with delegates who have their advocacies deeply rooted on their childhood, like Azine here. I mean, it's pretty much clear that your childhood and how your family or your parents brought you up, it's already like an indication of who you are as a person and how it like developed you into this earth warrior right now. We're gonna talk more about your advocacy in detail in a little bit, because we Emin and I, we both have a lot of questions about that specific part of your advocacy. Thank you, Azine.
Thank you very much.
See you in a bit.
See you in a bit.
And great. And yeah, and great second delegate. My God, I'm so happy that both of our delegates have good internet connection, Emin, right?
Yes, yes. I'm also glad. Now let's go to the next one. And I hope, let's see, from the backstage, I can see a few people with their cameras on.
Yay! Okay.
Chat down below at we have Sandra, Adenike, and Uka down below. Let's see.
Right.
If Adenike's internet connection is already stable. Adenike or Uka, if you can hear us, please type in the private chat who are ready between the two of you. Otherwise, we're going to go back to our two other ladies, okay, so that we can interview them as well. While we're waiting for the rest of our people to have their internet connections stabilized, let's look back at the first of our two ladies. We have Sanik and Ezine.
Okay? Yeah.
Why don't we show our Earthlings the facts about them first?
Yeah. Yeah, great.
Sure. So now, let's start with some of the facts. Sanik, okay? Kinetsuko. Here we go, Sanik, ladies and gentlemen. You go. That was Sanik. So you got to know different facts about Sanik already. I love that. She has a lot of talents, also skills, and also a lot of her passion. Even extend her advocacy even extends to her passions and the things that she loves to do. Right. So thank you very much.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, and you know what, Emin? I love the fact that the organization had these 10 facts about the delegates, because we get to know a little bit more about the delegates outside their advocacies, right?
Right, there you go. And now, it's time for us to discover some facts about Ezine.
Hello, I'm Ezinofia, contesting for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. I'm a huge traditional lover. I'm a lover of our culture, our food, our dance, our music. And this love for my culture ignited me to start the hashtag Mother Tongue Challenge for kids. Here, these kids are just expected to introduce themselves in their different native dialects and just give us basic information about themselves. The love for my rich cultural heritage made me want to know more, and this made me love traveling. I visited 20 states in Nigeria. I visited all eastern states and a few of the northern and southern states. I love meeting people. I love knowing more about their culture, their lifestyle, their belief, and most especially trying out new food. For a model, I think you're not meant to be tagged a foodie, but I'm not a foodie, but I'm open to trying new food. And for someone who is open-minded about trying new food, I actually don't like a lot of seafood when it comes to catfish, shrimps, lobsters. Literally, if I'm served that in a restaurant, I would run off.
No!
Really? Oh, thinking about it, I think I have chills. Mother Earth has really blessed us, and I'm a huge lover of nature. I love taking random pictures of beautiful sceneries, flowers, grasses, animals, anything that attracts me, basically. I post it on my Instagram, on Facebook account with hashtag randoms. Growing up and not having enough land space, I've always wanted to have my very own garden, plant it myself, water it, tending to my garden like a mother tending to her child. Talking about tending to it like a mother tending to her child, my sweet spots are actually kids. I love children. I love hanging out with them. I love their innocence. I love their inquisitive nature. And if you are one that relates and hang out with kids a lot, there's a lot to learn from kids.
Form a big circle. So my magic cup game is very simple. This is the magic cup.
Being that girl that always has her glasses on, I'm actually tagged as being quiet. But really, I'm actually very goofy. When I'm in my circle or in my zone with my people, I'm actually tagged as the life of the party. I just want people to know that I'm actually not that quiet girl in glasses. I've actually been termed weird, but I feel it's just my way of relating with music. I prefer to stay in a room with little ray of light and listening to in-house music.
And I rise up, I like the waves, I rise up.
This is a fun fact I think I'm sort of ashamed to talk about. I'm a huge crybaby. I cry about literally everything. I can cry while watching a movie. I can cry while listening to music. I cry while laughing. Like, I don't know. I cry about basically everything. And who said a pageant girl can't have it all? A huge lover of pageants. I've gone for the Nigerian Queen, the most beautiful girl in Nigeria, and now I'm contesting for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. I'm also an entrepreneur who runs two businesses. So I hope you enjoy watching this video as much as I enjoyed shooting it, and I hope this gives you a glimpse of me as you work with me in my Miss Earth journey. Ciao.
Yes, Noni, you're on mute.
Am I okay now?
Yes, you are. Wow, that was great.
Yeah,
production value.
Exactly. Well-produced, fun facts video. Congratulations to Ezine for that. Yes, there you
reminds
go.
She reminds me of the fun facts about videos of our Mr.
Yes.
Thing, right? How they do it also. So
yes.
Thank you very much for that. Thank you. So we got to know Sanik and Ezine already, both their introduction and fun facts about them. Let's see if we can get to know the rest of our ladies. And now let's continue with Praise Arthur. I hope her internet connection is stable, but I see her video backstage. So let's see. Hi, Praise Arthur. Here we go.
Greetings, everyone. I'm Praise Arthur by name. I'm a delegate of the Miss Earth Nigeria 2021 edition. I am from Akwa Ibom State, and I am also representing my state of origin, which is Akwa Ibom State. My environmental advocacy is Natural Resources Defense Council. Alright guys, let's take a quick one. What is natural resources? Natural resources can be defined as the resources that exist on the planet independently on its own. These are the resources that are found in the environment and are developed without the interruption or interventions of humans. For example, we have the air, the sunlight, the water, the soil, the stone, the plants, the animals, and fossil fuels. Okay, and all these natural resources do not have any side effects. The only side effect we are confronting at the moment is we humans that cause the side effects. For example, air. The disadvantages of air is the air pollution that we are causing. Take for instance, the smoke that comes out from our vehicle or generator or bush burning. All those smokes are unhealthy to the health of humans. So it is time for us to just end this air pollution. Alright, let's take a quick one. What about the water? We cause water pollution because of the inappropriate waste disposal. The way we dispose waste can affect us directly or indirectly. Even the seafood in the sea are choking. We are even killing the seafood in the sea. They are even dying because of the plastic we dispose in the water. So, it is time for you and I to make a change and put on an inappropriate waste disposal. Let's manage our waste and let's take good care of Mother Earth, all these natural resources that we are enjoying, that I have listed here, is our responsibility for you and I to protect them because it is for our own good. Thank you guys so much for your love and support. And thank you for Miss Earth Nigeria for giving me this opportunity to be part of this addiction. I love you all.
There you go. That was great. Wow. Okay. Arthur, however,
yes.
Just as I was playing Grace's video, she got disconnected from the stream. So hopefully she can come back.
Okay.
Her later. Yeah. So Noy.
You know what, Eman? Yeah, you know what, Eman? I have a feeling Praise is a teacher. Don't you think?
Really? Why?
Yeah, because of how she like explains, you know, the information. We have to find out if she is a teacher indeed. Yeah. I'm interested to find out.
Who knows that she might be? Maybe that will come out in her 10 fun facts about her video. So why don't we watch that right now?
Exactly.
Right? So after the introduction,
love that. Yes. Praise,
after the introduction of Praise Arthur, let's watch the 10 facts about her.
Hello everyone. My name is Praise Arthur, and one of the delegates of the Nigeria 2021 election. I want to tell you all 10 fun facts about me. Number one fun fact about me is that I love cooking. I need to enjoy the food that I cook. I have so much enjoy the food. Number two fun fact about me is that I am an easygoing person. I treat everyone, I treat everyone before, I treat everyone with kindness. I believe you that you're short, you're tall, you're slim, you're fat. We are all wonderful. Fish, crabs, prawns, food. I really love how weather saves life. Number 7 fun fact about me is that I love washing dishes and I love cleaning dishes, but not how to do this. Number 8 fun fact about me is that I'm lazy when it comes to exercise. Do I work on that? Number 9 fun fact about me is that I love plants. I remember when I was a child, my stepmom and my dad would always cook for me, but my favorite plant is
There you go. You know what? I love the fact that all of our delegates have either oozing with so much personality, right, Em?
Exactly. Exactly. And of course, praise is not an exception, because she has this very animated personality. That's why we thought she was a teacher, right?
Yeah, I'd love to be her friend. Praise, if you're listening, I'd love to be your friend. Yes, because you seem so much fun based on your video.
There you go. So we already saw four of our ladies.
Four.
Yes. Would you like to check the comment section first before we go to the next one?
Please.
Yes, please. All right. So we have... Oh, there you go. So Neil Bryan Rivera is watching from Marikina City, Philippines. So we are being watched in different countries.
Hi, Neil.
We have Canada also. And then we have, of course, from Marikina. And then Angela Talosa says, Miss Earth is always amazing. Yes, right? And Nikki Hi, Morris agrees. Nikki says, this is amazing as well. There you go. Ebby Tasha Root says, go Amazons, you are doing absolutely well. Yes, I agree. They are doing absolutely well. I love what it says. Calm down, babes. Yes. Well, because you're just losing so much energy, right? Right? Oh. Jay actually says, Grace may be a famous vlogger. I love her energy.
Yeah.
Right? Right? And Ibn Abo is saying, well done. Madam is saying, well done, Amazons. Yes, there you go. And also, a supporter of Ezine is right here saying, well done, Ezine Ofia.
Wow.
Thank you very much. So far, those are our comments from the comment section right now. There you go. Would you like to go to the next?
Yes.
Our next candidate?
Yes. Okay. Actually, Ems, we are done with... I think more than half of our delegates so far. Now let's move on to our fifth Amazon for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. Let's see this.
Hello, Philippines. Hello, Nigeria. And hello to the rest of the world. It's a great honor and privilege to be on this platform and getting the opportunity to fight for a cause that benefits every being on Earth. My name is Adenike Adebayo. I am from and representing Kwara State. I am an undergraduate student of Ahmad Bello University College of Medical Sciences. My advocacy is geared towards apprehending the environmental problems Nigeria and the rest of the world is facing. Waste management, afforestation, and reforestation have been selected. Waste management is very important at this point in time, as it is a major factor that contributes to the environmental problems the Earth is faced with. These wastes include fumes generated from our industries and automobiles, all forms of solid waste, especially the non-biodegradable ones, And so there is the need to take responsibility for the waste we have brought into existence. And we need to begin to see this already generated waste as materials that could be used to make other things, just the way we consider raw materials to be plastic, could be melted, then to make durable floor coverings, and so on and so forth. And while we are doing that, let's not forget that we are losing our forests and sources of oxygen to fire and urbanization. And so afforestation and reforestation is meant to combat that. And I have volunteered with some NGOs that help establish waste management sites in every state in Nigeria. And so whether or not I win, my advocacy will be upheld, but the Miss Earth Nigeria platform will help me reach a bigger audience and bring it to a larger scope. Thank you for having me.
That was amazing.
All
you know
right.
What? Yes.
So,
I agree with her that Miss Earth Nigeria is such a big platform so that...
Okay, whatever, there. Whatever so what can you say, Eman, about...
Yes. So, Noy... so Noy is also... We're also having a time delay with Noy right now. But yes, there you go. Cap it lang, Noy. There, yes. But as I was saying, I like how... Adenike... emphasize that this is a big platform for her. Let's try if we can chat
yes.
with let's try if we can chat with Adenike right now. She's on audio right now. Adenike, are you there? Adenike, let's see if we can hear. She can't turn on her camera because of internet connection, but it says that she is connected on audio. Are you there? Okay, so maybe Adenike is lagging right now. So before we go to Adenike again. But for now, let's go back to the lady who we introduced
okay.
a while ago, okay, and who we already showed her 10 facts. So maybe we can ask her personally if she's really a teacher, Noy. Let's bring back Praise Arthur. Praise, are you there?
Oh, it's Praise.
Yes. Let's see. Let's see if her internet connection is stable right now. There you go. There she is. Look at her. She's so beautiful. Hi, Praise. Can you hear us? Apparently not. Okay, there you go. Thank you very much. That's okay. So let's continue. We already showed the introduction video of Adenike. Now I think it's time for us to show her 10 facts about her.
Hello, teacher and coach Adenike Adebayo. I am a 24 years old student of Madvelo University, studying human physiology, and I am a delegate for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. And I will be sharing 10 fun facts about me that you may or may not know already. So stay tuned. Fact number one, it is true that breakfast is the most important meal of the day, but you may want to keep serving me breakfast if you don't want me feeling drowsy all through the day. The next fact is, I love animals a lot and I keep many pets. I keep cats, birds, and even rats at some point. Trust me, they're adorable. The third fun fact about me is, I love natural water bodies. I love the feel and the view of the ocean, but being around one gives me shivers. Gives me goosebumps. Fourth fun fact is, I am afraid of heights, but I love mountain climbing. But the fear of falling keeps me from trying. The next fact is, I love hiking. I love going into the woods a lot. The fear of snakes and creepy crawlies always reminds me it's time to return home. The next fact is, I love all colors, and it's really difficult to tell which ones I love best. But have a soft spot for black color. I feel you can never be over or underdressed in a little black dress. So whenever I need to grace an occasion and I'm finding it difficult deciding what to wear and bearing in mind not to be over or underdressed for the occasion, I just pick up my little black dress. We know water is life. Sometimes I don't remember to drink water after a meal or two or even three. So I had to download an app that helps me monitor my water intake in order to remain hydrated. Another fun fact about me is I don't like trends. I don't like trendy movies or music. Not that I don't watch trendy movies or listen to trendy music, but I just like them better when they are not trendy anymore. So I love old school music very, very much. The next fun fact is I participated and won my first pageant at the age of 10 in primary 6. The school hosts an annual beauty and fashion competition during the inter-house sporting events, and they group their pupils into various houses. There's a yellow house, green house, red house. I was in the yellow house and I represented my house and won the competition. I have always been driven to take up challenges, even at an early age. Such challenges that help modify and reshape me into a better version of myself. And when I believe in certain causes, I stand firmly by my beliefs, and others' opinion don't influence my decisions, except of course they are inclined with my beliefs. And last but not the least fact, did you know that I was once rescued by a dog? Well, now you know. At age 6, I wandered out of the house without my parents' consent, and I couldn't find my way back. But my dog was able to find me. And how it was able to find me, considering how far I ventured, remained a mystery for a long time. I guess the single act contributed to why I love animals so much, and they hold a special place in my heart. And my love for them have triggered the hunger to fight for certain causes that would help make the earth a better place for them. This is what I seek, and this is all I stand for, making the earth a better place for them and for everyone else. So there you have it, 10 fun facts about Adenike that you now know. Thank you.
There you Yay. Go. That was
Those are
the cousin
yes,
lovers.
Exactly. Lover. And you know what? I think yes, I think Adenike has quite a colorful childhood. I am just really fascinated with the fact that she won her first pageant at the age of 10. Can you believe that, Ems?
That is right. 10 years old. What a great start. That's why she seems like a true veteran. The way she like handles herself seems like a true veteran. Thank you very much for that. Wow. We're almost done introducing our candidates, but of course, we still have more to introduce. So now let's go to our next one. Let's see. Well, let's see if Grace is ready to chat with us. Are you there, Grace? Can you hear us better? Looking beautiful right there. Okay, but
wow.
Nine. Okay. Here she is. I can see some movement. Hi.
Yeah.
Okay, so Brace is still lagging a little bit, right? So we'll go back to later on. Don't worry about it.
You know what, Ems? For a while, I thought you were also frozen because you were like that. I thought you were like that.
What?
Are you
okay.
frozen?
No, I'm not. Okay. So...
I hate you. I thought you were frozen. Look at...
Don't worry about it. All right. Now let's go to our next candidate. So we are already done with, let's give a check, right? So we're done with Edzine. And then we are done with Stanik. And then, of course, with Adenike. And then we already had also, just recently, the last one, we also had Praise Arthur.
Praise, yes.
Yes, okay. Now, let's go to our next lady, okay? So we don't have her here yet. But here is our next lady. Actually, some of our ladies that we are introducing today were already around yesterday, but because of internet connection, they were not able to make it. So we are giving them another platform and another chance today. Okay? But before that, let's introduce our next candidate.
Hello, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to our show hosts and all our viewers across the globe. Thank you for having me on the show. My name is Judith Ame, and I'm representing Benue State in the ongoing Miss Earth Nigeria 2021 pageant. I'm a lawyer, I'm a writer, I'm a published author of the book Slavery Has a New Name, The Menace of Human Trafficking. My environmental advocacy is waste recycling for monetization. I'd love to use my platform to educate people on the dangers of plastic pollution. It has been said that about 26% of the 1,000 fish species we have in Nigeria are endangered species due to plastic waste and, of course, habitat depletion. I'll use my platform as a lawyer to advocate for the enactment of environmental-friendly laws to tackle this phenomenon. I'll also use my platform to tackle the practicability of these environmental laws. I would love to create awareness, teaching school children on the importance of waste recycling and the dangers of plastic pollution. I'll carry out awareness to ensure partnership amongst all sectors across the country to
there you go. Yeah.
You know what, Noy? All of them have.
So that was. Yeah.
Yes.
Aman.
Yes. I was just checking because we have time delay. You're having time delay with me as well. I was just saying that all of our ladies have beautiful advocacies. And of course, Judith is not an exception. Okay. Now let's go straight to the facts.
Yeah.
Get to know Judith. I also like the production value of her video. Let's watch this.
Enemies steady blocking my way. But me, I'm steady making my way. I did another level. I did another level. Me, I know the find.
Hello, everybody. My name is Judith Ame. I'm the running towards becoming the next Miss Earth Nigeria 2021 queen. 10 fun facts about me are, I love to cook, I love to clean, I love to wash, I love to write, I'm a great writer actually, I'm a lawyer, I love to sing, I love to dance, I love to travel, I travel a lot, I'm a great researcher. I founded an organization called Legal Action Against Trafficking in Persons, where I take steps towards combating human trafficking. I love environmental advocacy, and which is why I'm in this pageant. My pet project is on waste recycling for a cleaner and healthier environment. Thank you.
There you go. That was Judith. Love
you know,
it.
I was watching Judith through the monitor, my monitor also, and it's so amazing how she transformed, because from her introduction video, she was very simple and, you know, very herself. And then she transformed into a gorgeous woman with, what do you call this, with all the makeup. So our Earth Queens are capable not only of putting forward their advocacies, but also of presenting themselves very well in front of people. And that is amazing.
Exactly, yes. And that's what you call Judith as an example of a glamazon.
Correct. And there you go.
She's Judith the glamazon. Yes.
I love it.
And you know what? Yes, and you know what, Ems? I think the organization should consider awarding the best 10 fun facts video because the girls are doing a great job. calling the national director.
Gabrielle.
Yes.
Suggestion. We have two more to go, Noy. No? Yesterday, some of our ladies were not able to make it. Actually, one of them was Judith. We have one more. Okay, one of them was Judith. And then today, we are having one more lady, okay? So this time, let's get to know her.
Hey guys, right. My name is Okamata Eze, and I'm a delegate of the Miss at Nigeria 2021. And here is a video with 10 fun facts about me. So fun fact number one is, I'm quite spontaneous and I love adventures. I'm always excited about new opportunities. I have been to Monsieur Tunia, the Smugglers Thunders, that's Victoria Falls and Zimbabwe. And one day I would love to visit the Great Walls of China and the Taj Mahal in India. I love nature so much. I also love the fact that it is beautiful and nobody can control nature. And the only thing that we can do is protect our Mother Earth and preserve it. I feel by destroying nature, we are destroying ourselves. We should always make a difference by conserving the limited amount of several resources the Earth has. We should educate each other to plant more trees to prevent global warming, and that will also benefit all the living organisms on planet Earth. Nothing is faster to bring my mind and body back into balance than a good laugh. I love watching comedy. My favorite comedy shows I watched as I grew up were Seinfeld, The Big Bang Theory, and My Wife and Kids. I enjoy drawing. I create my own artwork as a hobby. I think every person is a different kind of artist. You could imagine anything, put in color and on paper, and become something extraordinary. I used to play tennis in high school. I also enjoy playing volleyball. The sports I like watching are basketball and hockey. And my best all-time tennis player is Serena Williams. When I was a little girl, I enjoyed science experiments. I used to set up water experiments at home because they were the easiest to set up, and my parents wouldn't get worried of me blowing up the entire house because of my little weird experiments. I like reading stuff-up books. I feel they center on encouraging personal improvement in different aspects of life. I've read 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership by Jay Maxwell and Straight Talk, No Chaser by Steve Harvey, just to mention a few. If I had to eat one type of food for the rest of my life, it would be fruits. I like fruits so much. Fruits are more like my comfort food. Whenever I'm sad, I always like eating fruits. I'm against discrimination. I think that even on the grounds of race, age, sex, and disability, we all should receive equal opportunities, be it at school or at work. I think we should all stand against discrimination in peace and harmony because we are all one, despite our differences. If I knew I would be reincarnated as an animal, the animal I would be is a tiger. I consider tigers to be adventurous, not only are they strong, they're beautiful, they are nocturnal animals, they are good swimmers too. I like tigers. So those are the 10 fun facts about me. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day. Bye.
There you have it. That was Uka.
Yes, Uka. Actually, that was the 10 fun facts about her. Okay. I labeled them wrong. I thought that was already her intro. Okay. But that was the 10 fun facts about Uka.
Yeah.
But before, in just a little bit, we're going to bring back the rest of the ladies, all of them together. But before that, let's watch one last video again because we already got to know Uka. How about her advocacy? Okay, let's get to know Uka's advocacy with her proper intro video. Here she is.
Hello, everyone. My name is Okamaka Eze, and I am a delegate of the Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. I love the Earth and its environment. I mostly love trees. I am advocating for afforestation, which is the process of planting of trees in areas of no trees to create a forest. I strongly believe that afforestation can create ecological balance to manage the rising population and its effects. Soil erosion, pollution, and ecological imbalance can only be treated by planting more trees. Afforestation helps to slow down global warming, by reducing the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and producing more oxygen. Afforestation has many benefits, and the ones I've just mentioned are the most basic ones. So let's make the earth a better place and plant more trees.
There you go. Thank you very much, Puka. And that completes all of our candidates' introduction. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen, for making it. That is the Earth Voice 2021 Miss Nigeria meet and greet. So now we have some ladies backstage. If you are still connected and you'd like to turn your cameras on,
yes,
you can
please
already do that so we can put you back here on stage. And so we can all chat together. And now we have the special participation of Dexter the Cat. Hi, Dexter.
And he agrees that this is a really great batch of delegates. He loved the videos, right, Dexter? He loved the videos.
Correct.
He agrees.
But before we bring our ladies back, let's look at the comment section.
Yeah,
JP says, happy to see you compete again, Adenike. And another supporter of Adenike says, of course, well done. Nice one, Adenike. And then we have another supporter here who says, Ezine for the win. Okay, our supporter out already. Genevieve says, nice one, Amazon Queens. And way to go, Amazons. There you go. We have supporters of Ezine saying, Ezine of Fia for Miss Earth. Madam Ibinabo actually says, great job to everyone, to all of the candidates. But I'm reading here her her greetings to Judith. Right,
you go. Yeah,
you're doing great, according to Genevieve. And then Henry supports Sani. Yes, and Vanessa Faith waves the flag of the Philippines as well. Thank you very much to our candidates. What do you think about them so far, Noy?
You know what? If there's also one thing that I'd like to point out is that aside from the candidates, one thing that is pretty consistent about Miss Earth Nigeria is the fan base. I mean, they have been so supportive ever since we had the perfect chance of interviewing Gwen last year. They have been so supportive of their delegates.
And
right? That's why I think Miss Earth Nigeria is thriving in their country because of the support and love of the Earthlings in Nigeria. There you
go. Yes. So why don't we bring back our ladies right now? I see backstage three ladies. We have Ezine, we have Adenike, and Uka. Let's see who are connected right now. Let's bring them back up on stage. Adenike is streaming with audio only. Okay, so Uka is also streaming with audio only. Praise's device isn't connected right now, unfortunately. So it's still waiting to connect. Adenike, can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you. Hello.
There you go. Yeah. Perfect, perfect. Mm-hmm. As soon as you're able to reconnect with video. But right now, audio is fine. How about Uka? Uka, can you hear us?
Yeah, perfect. There.
Uka, can you hear us, Uka? Okay, how about Praise? Praise is still connecting right now. All right, Noy, so why don't we talk to Ezine first? Noy? My God, everybody's having a... okay, Noy, are you there? Noy is also reconnecting right now, so let's... have Noy reconnect before.
Yeah, Ezine, hi. Yes. Noy, I'm here. Yeah, I'm here.
Yes.
Power bank.
Yes, and Noy is back right now. There you go. We can hear you, Noy. We can hear you. Ezine, you have a lot of supporters. Ezine, Ofia for Miss Earth, and aside from this, Shibugo Amadi, you also have a lot of supporters down at the comment section below. Now, I have a question here from one of our fans. Her name is Joy Sabido Pinganon. Okay. Sorry. Why did you choose to join? For those who chose to join again, this is her question. But for those who are joining for the first time, why did you choose to join the Miss Earth pageant? In your case, Ezine, why did you choose to join the Miss Earth Nigeria pageant?
Okay. I chose to join the Miss Earth Nigeria pageant means so much to me. It feels like home. Because growing up and having been taught a lot of environmental friendly activities, being a part of the Miss Earth journey for me is like continuing my daily life, because I now get to show people things I do on a daily basis through the eco activities, and I also get to learn more from it. So choosing the Miss Earth platform is just, choosing the Miss Earth pageant is just a place for me to be able to reach out and educate more people on the importance of engaging themselves in environmental friendly activities, and for me to be able to face one very major problem that's affecting my country, and that's why I vote for waste management, to teach people on how to manage their waste properly. And Miss Earth Nigeria is the best place to showcase that and the best platform for me to be able to earn that. So that's why I chose the Miss Earth Nigeria platform. And winning the Miss Earth Nigeria would not only make me a beautiful queen, but I would best advance as an environmental advocate too.
That is true.
Thank you.
That is true. I agree. Yes. So the Miss Earth pageant, wherever it is, especially in Nigeria, gives you two chances. It could be two things, a queen and a forever, a solid and certified environmental advocate. So there you go. So it goes a lot of great ways. So that is the question from Joy Sabido Ping Canon. Adenik, are you there? Can you hear us? Oh, there you go. Adenik, we lost Adenik there. Let's see if Grace is, and then Judith also trying to reconnect. And then Uka is also trying to connect. Ruka is connected through audio. Uka, can you hear us?
I'm on the internet mode.
Yes, and there you go. Two users are in stream with audio only. Adenik, can you hear me?
There you go, Adenik.
So Joy has a question right here, because I believe that you, this is another time for you to join Miss Earth Nigeria. Okay, so if this is your second time to join, or another time to join, or why did you choose to join Miss Earth Nigeria once again?
Yes.
All right. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Adenik, for that answer. You know, to make the platform better, you know, to coming back as a better candidate. Yes, there you go. That sums up Adenike's intentions and reasons for joining Miss Earth Nigeria once again. Noi, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, so we have Adenik right now. And Ezine also, do you have any question for Ezine or Adenik?
Actually, for Ezine, I have a question. How exactly do you think your joining Miss Earth Nigeria is going to help you in promoting your advocacy
I mean, what is the goal in your mind? Why you joined Miss Earth Nigeria in terms of your advocacy? Did Ezine hear?
I think Ezine, mute your mic. I think your mic is muted. Yes, there you go.
Yes.
No problem.
Miss Earth Nigeria is a pageant that moves to promote environmental and crown beauty for a cause. So, contesting the Miss Earth Nigeria platform is going to help me move forward in my advocacy because, like I earlier stated, the major problem facing, one of the major problems we're facing in Nigeria is improper waste management. And as an organization that is concerned about promoting environmental friendly behaviors, they would stand along with me in trying to sensitize every member of my country, starting one state and one region at a time, on the importance of collecting and dealing with their waste properly. And also finding good use of some of those materials which they already gather with, such as plastic, tires, old clothes, and other materials that have been gathered with. The Earth platform is, the Earth pageant is hoping to find queens that are willing to stand and speak up for certain environmental problems that are happening in their country. And I'm here to serve as a support and a guide and a platform for me to move forward with that project. So I'm very certain that the Miss Earth platform is the right place for me to move forward with my advocacy on waste management through promotion of recycling of plastic bottles and tires. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yes. Thank you very much for that, Ezine. Okay, Adine, are you there? All right.
Yes,
so, Noi, do you have any question for Adine, or is it the same question? Let's wait.
Mm-hmm. There you have, great. Yeah.
Hi, Adinique. Yes, actually, Adinique, I have a very specific question for you. I mean, because I found out that you had a colorful childhood. We were mentioning a while ago that you joined or you won your very first pageant at the age of 10. Now, my question, Adinike, is, for example, a young Nigerian girl is watching right now and she wants to join Miss Earth Nigeria in the future. What would be your tip? What would be your advice to that young girl who wants to join the pageant in the future?
Well, thank you very much for the question. My advice to a young girl who would want to join in the Earth Advent future will be for her to be herself. And she should be really passionate about the environment to want to be a part of Miss Earth Advent. Because Miss Earth Nigeria does not only crown queens based on their physical or their looks only. They sort out for girls better other qualities that go beyond physical appearance. And so the young girl should be someone who loves the environment and has specific changes she wants to bring about in the society generally. She should be more concerned about bringing an end to the environmental problems we are facing in Nigeria and the rest of the world. This would be my advice to her.
Wow, that's a really great advice. And I do hope a lot of young girls out there are listening to you right now. Thank you so much, Adinike, for that answer. Congratulations. Eman, there you go. Who do we have next?
Yes, unfortunately, the rest of our ladies are unable to connect to the internet tonight. So right now we have Edine and Adinik. Yes, Uka is around, but she's also having a hard time connecting. Okay, let's try one last time. Uka, can you hear us? I think she's also having a hard time connecting because she chatted in our chat. Box, she says, hello, everyone. Hi, Emman. It's good to see you again. Would have really loved to talk. So that was from Uka. And I know that it would have been a nice conversation, of course. But I'm so glad, Noy, that today we were able to at least see everybody through their introduction videos and their 10 facts about you videos. So thank you very much, Miss Earth Nigeria, for that plan, for having that as as a backup. So Miss Earth Nigeria, I just so love that Miss Earth Nigeria is on their toes and are thinking of ways on how to actually present our ladies properly. So we had some internet problems. Okay, let's think of a solution. Here we go. Let's make some introduction videos. Let's make some get to know you, getting to know them videos. And so at least today, we were able to know every single one of them through their videos. And of course, we were able to interview those who have good internet connection, like we did with Adinik, like we did with Sanik, and now we have with Ezine. Okay, so
thank you.
But is there any other question that you'd like to ask?
You know what? Actually, I don't have any more questions, but I'd like to find out what is in store for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. So what can the fans expect? I mean, what's going to happen in the next few weeks or days of the competition? Maybe we can ask Ezine, what do we have to expect for the competition?
There's a lot to expect. I think you all should just sit back and prepare to be amazed. We've had a lot of content to do. We've made a lot of beautiful videos to show to you.
Wow.
Give you guys more information about ourselves, our advocacies, and how we intend to bring that forward. So it's a very wonderful opportunity to be contesting for Miss Earth Nigeria because it's an organization that is well-structured and well-planned and tries to start a very good way to be able to showcase ourselves as much as they can. So I would just tell you guys, keep your fingers crossed and read because it's going to be a fun fact part left for you guys to see. Yes.
Yay! Thank you so much, Ezine. Well, I also have the same question for do we have Adinike on audio?
Judith is also trying to connect to audio. Let me ask Judith first. Judith, are you here? Can you hear us?
Yeah.
Okay, maybe Judith is not.
She's
having her time. How about Adenike? Can you hear us, Adenike?
Adenike, yeah.
Oh, I think also Adenike is losing
Okay, now maybe since we have the last woman standing, Ezine, right here, we're going to give you the opportunity to invite all of the fans, okay? This the floor is yours to represent all of our lovely ladies for Batch 2. What can you say to all of the fans? Invite them to the competition, to the events of the competition. The floor is yours now, Ezine.
Okay. Thank you, everyone that tuned in to watch us today. Sorry I'm not sure I could allow my fellow Amazons to come on today. But I'm speaking with all of them from love from my heart, telling you thank you for coming on. Still stay tuned because we're going to be having an opportunity to get to meet more of the contestants tomorrow. And keep in love to Miss Earth Nigeria page, but on Instagram and on Facebook because there's a lot to see. And if you have the opportunity to get to meet the girls one-on-one. It's a one-on-one meet and buy videos, but we get to know so much about them because we're all pouring out our hearts and our advocacies to you all. Thank you from wherever you're loving, Philippines, Canada, Nigeria. Thank you all very much.
Yay! Thank you so much, Ezine. You know what, Emman? I think it's divine providence that Ezine is the one last standing right here, right now, because she was able to give like a great like message to all of the Miss Earth Nigeria fans to invite them to the competition, right, Ems?
Yes, on behalf of all the Amazons of Miss Earth Nigeria, of course. So thank you very much, Ezine.
Yes.
Everyone. All right, so that's it for Ezine. Thank you very much, Ezine. I'm going to give put you back on backstage. Thank you. See you again later on. There you go. Thank you very much. So now, Noy, I think that ends our session for
yes. You know what? This has been, I think, like a better session from yesterday, because we were able to still know about the candidates through their videos. But yes, of course, we are still expecting the best this coming 27th of March for our last batch, right? Eman, what's in store for that last day of our interviews?
Yes, because for the last day of our interviews, not only are we meeting the third batch of our the Earth Voice 2021 candidates, the Miss Earth Nigeria candidates, but we are also going to meet, of course, the woman, the lady Yay! Behind the success of Miss Earth Nigeria, Madame Ibenabo. And we are
Yes, exactly. And Madame Ibenabo has been so supportive of Miss Earth Crown from the very beginning. Madam, we're so excited to chat with you finally. This is a dream come true. We're so excited for that one.
Yes, thank you very much. But for the meantime, of course, that is it for tonight. But thank you very much. As usual, thank you, Earthlings, for joining us.
Exactly. And to all of our Earthlings from around the world, Philippines, Canada, and Nigeria, from wherever you are around the world, maraming maraming salamat. This has been day two of our The Earth Voice for Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. This has been your host, Noy Sabilan, and of course, my co-host, Emmanuel Feliciano. And of course, on behalf of all of the delegates who were here tonight, this is Miss Earth Crown TV. Maraming maraming salamat. Gabrielle Bernal, thank you so much. Madam Ibenabo, thank you so much. Please stay tuned to Miss Earth Crown for more updates on Miss Earth Nigeria 2021. But for the meantime, we say thank you, stay safe, and have a great Sunday, everyone. Maraming maraming salamat po. Bye!